over those shoulders. Breathing. Getting those arms up. Go back to those backstroke. That's it. Reach it up.
I was telling you no lies and I was loving you.
And reach it out. And up. Oh, my dog's getting excited. Someone's coming in the front door. Take a big breath. Alright. Get your hips. Very good. Just get them loose. Sets of three. One, two, three. That's it. That's it. One more. Let's take those hips all the way around. Very good. And the other way. Step touch. We're going to clean windows. Remember, they can start as small windows, but we want it to get bigger. One, we're loosening up the shoulders. And we're starting to bring the heart rate up a little bit. Other way. That's it. Very good. Now, step touch. We're going to add those heel taps. Heel down, toe up, elbows coming back. You're breathing. Standing tall. Alright, now the toes are tapping back. Arms are going front. That's it. Let's take the arms up. Bring it back to the front. And take them up. We do those in sets of two. Two front, two up. How about singles? Another one. All right, we're going to clear off the table right there. Remember, it can start as a small table. Let's see if you can get it bigger. Again, raising our heart rate while really loosening up the upper body. Oh, we're going to reach up. That's it. How about to the front with a fist? That's it. You are breathing. Whatever you need to do to remind yourself, keep breathing. And a hook. Maybe it's singing, counting, talking, whatever it is. All right, we're thinking that bring the arm up the side. Remember, you can choose to only go shoulder height if you like. If your shoulder's okay with it, you can go higher. That's it. Should be feeling kind of warm. Very good. Now, we're going to do those hamstring curls. Heels coming up towards your rear, pulling back in a row. Now, at any point you need to switch to a step touch, you can, but this will really wake up your legs, warm them up at the chest. All right, let's reach it overhead. Very good, big move. How about back at the chest? And row. Let's pull, belly button in. Let's do both. All right. Heel taps, or they could be kicks. How about straight ahead? You can lead him with a heel. Or you can tap if you prefer. Cross him over. To the front. Very good. Nice work. Grab your drink and grab the single weight. So it could be one of your regular weights, or it could be a heavier one if you like. We're going to start with a step forward with this one. Now, it can just be a step forward. It can just be a shifting of your weight if you like. You're going to decide. You stay facing me. You can hear. It's a lunge. You can turn it into a deeper lunge or not. Or it can just be a step. Now, we're going to hold the weight this way, and we're going to row a boat. All right, but we're going to add it with a step. So, again, it could be a small step. It's on the same side as the step. Row, belly button in. Now, anytime we do a rotation, you're working core. Now, if you have a problem with any of it, then you can take these and separate them. Just do one and then the other. Again, it can be a small step or a big step. Now, let's just do the row. Right, left. Just focus on the row. You're in control. It's core. Do four more. Four, three, two, one. Very good. All right, now we're going to bring the palms are up, all right? Weight is here, feet are spread apart. Think of a letter V in front of you. And we're just going to move in the shape of a V. Now pull that belly button in, but don't hold your breath. You are breathing. You're taking it up, palms are up and right, left. Again, this is a compound move. We're working a lot of muscles. Core in particular, you should feel it at work. But of course, your shoulders, your biceps, your chest. Very good. A couple more. One more step here. Here's the last one. Very good. Now we're going to do a deadlift. If you remember the deadlift, it really starts with just a squat. Back, we're going to do it slow up. So it's very important to think of your rear end as moving away from you. It's like on a train track and it's going back and away. The knees don't go forward at all. Do one more squat. Back. Very good. Now what we're going to do is put that heavier weight in one hand on your right. Because in a deadlift, you can tend to lift more weight. And we're just going to let our weight slide down in front of us. Let me turn this way. So you can just slide it down. Maybe it just goes to the end of your knee. Now what our core has to do here, it could go further. It depends on how far your butt goes back. Because your glutes are driving this exercise. The weight pulled here is just a side deal. Now since it's on one side, the core over here is having to work harder to adjust. Very good. Let's switch sides. Just think of the weight as just sliding down your leg. Maybe it only goes to your knee. Butt is traveling away from you. Maybe it goes down further. Butt is back. This is how we pick up weight in from a low position. It's a squat. Very good. One more. All the work is really almost entirely located back here. Very good. We're going to start from the beginning. Remember that row? But we're stepping forward. So you make a step. It could be a small step. It could be a big step. And then we're growing. Now let's try doing the opposite thing. Now let's try rowing on the opposite side of the leg that's going out. So a different motion. A little easier to get back. Oh, we're almost out of time. One more. Keep it even. Very good. Put that down. Grab a drink if you need it. It's cardio. Here's old Staying Alive. We haven't done it in a while. This song is a lot of jacks. You decide how involved that jack's going to be. We're going to start with the right. Eight of them. So eight. Now remember, you can just do one arm. You can stick with just shoulder height. Four more. Four. Three. Two. One. Other side. Or you can do both arms. It's really up to you. The bigger the step, the more the work. So you decide. Two. Here's our little break with disco arms. Very good. Knee lifts are next. Knee lifts on the right. Now you can just be here. And on the left. So you can just be right here. Or you can make it harder by stepping back. All right. Challenge your belt to move. Other side. This is a range of motion and a heart rate deal. Are you ready to start it over? We're starting at the top. Eight of them again. You can choose to do both arms. Heart rate goes higher. Here is a small step or a big step. Bigger the step, higher the heart rate. Other side. Got it. There's four more. Four. Three. Two. One. Disco arms. All right. Knee lifts are next. Remember, they can be a very simple knee lift in the front. Or you can make it harder by coming from further back. Let's do two more. That's it. So it's just a, it could be a little one or a big one. Range of motion. John Travolta move. Other side. Four of them. Two more. Now we're marching. Now remember, it can be a simple march. If you feel like you need to let your heart rate come down, or my floor creaks. Or you can make them bigger steps. Add arms if you want to keep that heart rate up. My floor seems to be creaking more over the last year. Let's take about, since I've been working out on this floor so much. Hope I'm not wearing it out. All right, we're going back to the jacks. Sets of four. Four. Three. Two. To the left. Four. Three. Two. We're going to do sets of two right here. Two of them. Switch sides. Here come the singles. Four. Disco arms. That's it. Now remember which kind of knee lifts you want to do. We're going to do of them. The challenging one is to reach back two more, or you can just pick them up. Either one. Two more. John Travolta. One more. It helps bring that heart rate up. Two more. We're going to march it out to the end now. If you want to keep that heart rate up, make it a higher knee jog. Add arms. You've only got, like, I don't know, 15, 20 seconds. It's not much. Let's take them up if you want it a little higher. Make the arms bigger. You can control by how big your moves are. You decide. Almost there. Almost there. That's it. Just march on up and grab your drink and grab your strap. A drink and a strap. Seems like a strange combination. Keep moving. We don't want your heart rate to come down too fast. Grab that strap. I have my shorter one today. Start with, we're going to do bow and arrow. We haven't done this in a while. All right, so set your arms like you have a bow and arrow. Your right, left arm, this is your right, sorry, is straight, locked out. Left arm is going to pull back. Except we're not going to give, obviously, two, but four, three, two, release. Four, now squeeze your glutes and your core. Release, make sure you're breathing. Four, breathe, two, three, two, one. I can't count and talk clearly. One more. Four, brace your core, squeeze your glutes, two, one. Let's switch sides. So now your left arm is locked out. Your right arm is going to pull back. Four, three, two, one. So we're working our shoulders primarily. Four, but as we squeeze our glutes and brace our core, you'll feel it supporting it. Release. Four, three, two, one. One more set. Ready? Four. You should feel it. Three, two, one. Very good. Roll it back. Let's do it, because we're going to continue working the shoulders. Now we're going to focus on rotator cuff. You know this one well. And I like to do it all the time because our rotator cuffs are weak. You know the cue. Elbows are in like you're with a towel. It's the only thing holding it on. And we're reaching out. I should have taken allergy medicine. Two, one, release. Elbows are squeezing in. You feel them squeezing in as you're pulling out. Two, one, two more. Ready? Squeeze everything. Core, glutes, one, release. Last one. Elbows are in. Four, three, two, one. Very good. Shake it out. Now we're going to do one for our subscapularis. It is beneath the scapula. It's the lowest muscle in the chain of the rotator cuff, and it's harder to work, so it tends to be weak. So elbows in. We start in the same position. Do you remember this one? We're going out, but as we squeeze out, we're going to raise up, back, down. You should feel it. So elbows are in. You're pulling out. Up. Two. Squeeze your belly button in. One. Woo! Here we are. Push it in. Take it out. Up. Keep going out. Keep pulling out. In. In. You can feel hopefully the back of your shoulder working. Press in. Open up. You're pulling out as we go up. Pull it out as we go up. Good. Woo! Roll the shoulders back. Now take it nice and wide. Come above your head. Can you come behind a little bit? This is where I need my longer strap. Go to wherever's comfortable for you. Just opening up the shoulder and the chest. Woo! Just go as far as you can go. If you can't go all the way down with both arms, then try going down with one arm. Very good. Set your strap down. Grab your drink. It's time for some tennis. Tennis where you can control where the ball's going. All right, grab your racket. We're going to start with just some easy hits. Just easy hits coming straight across. But as you go, we're going to pivot a little so we get our core involved. I may not really know how to play tennis, but I know we want to use our core. Nice and now, if you want to hit harder, you can. You may need to slow it down, hit harder. That's up to you. Right now, we're going to serve it, so we're going to throw it up and come over. Up, over. Up, over. This is not my dominant arm, so I know it's not so pretty, but over. It's that movement we're going for. Not only to raise our heart rate, shoulder mobility. One of the first things, honestly, that a lot of people lose is all the range of motion up, particularly in their shoulder. Here we go, other side. Just hit the ball. We're just lobbing it back. But we're pivoting. Very good. And I think I like it. All right, now you can go if you want a bigger hit. You can go for it. Bigger hit. One more. Belly button in. All right, let's serve it. Serve. Overhand. Overhand. Big range. So the idea is this is what we're trying to get the arm to do all the way around, right? Throw it up and over. Up and over. So it's a mobility thing and it's a posture thing. If your posture is doing purging and lens this as well, that's why we always talk about posture. Very good. Now, here we are. We're ready to hit the ball. It's coming over to our right. So we're going to come over. Just pop it. We're switching hands. I know no one does that really. That's all right. We'll pretend like we're these amazing players. That's ambidextrous. I think I told you probably before that I had my roommate, my freshman year of college, was ambidextrous. She was a left-hander. I think Pat, that's you. That was taught to do things with the right hand. All right, now, forehand, backhand. It's right both ways. Forehand, backhand. Let's switch to backhand. Let's switch to the left. Forehand, backhand. All right, now, we're gonna come up to the net. Just hit it lightly. Come back here. Hit it any way you like back here. So pop it. You can come back here. We're gonna do right hand. You can be here. Or you can be overhead. Maybe they hit it high. Switch arms to the left. You can just whack it here. Pop it. Overhead. And our tennis game, the ball's staying right in the middle here. Easy to go. Easy to get. Very good. Now, coming over, double backhand. We are going for it now. Go for it, double backhand. Reminiscent of baseball. So we're going both ways. Very good. Come on, we're almost there. All right, come running up again. Tap it. Head it however you want. Switch arms. Switch arms, any way you want. Bump. Nice work, very good. Grab your drink, grab your weights. You're drinking your weights. This is where you might want to bring a chair over and go near one. Not for the first exercise, but for the next one. Go do a little chest. This can work your chest and your back. So palms are down. We're at the chest, and we're gonna go up here. So essentially like a chest press, but when you pull, think of pulling back, so pull back, push up, pull, push. If you do that, we get work in both directions. Chest, back. Belly button's in, you're breathing. Chest, back. Chest, back. Very good. Two more sets, last set here. Very good. Now, this is where if you want a chair, grab it. You might want it. We're going to work actually our hip flexors. Here's how we're going to do it. We're going to put a weight right here. And we're just going to do a knee raise. So your hip flexors, all of us pretty much in the Western world have tight hip flexors because we sit a lot. But it doesn't necessarily mean they're strong. So, but it's also single leg balance. Now, if this is a struggle for you, then just stick with that. If you want a little more challenge, straighten the leg out a little bit. Doesn't have to be a huge kick or anything. We don't want a kick. We want to generate it from the hip flexor. Two more. Last one. Let's switch sides. Shake it out. Other side. Move if you need something to hold on to here. Breathe. Very good. Now you can stick with this. If your balance feels okay, you can go with the leg being straighter. But again, we're not kicking. We're lifting. You can feel it coming from here and from your quads right on top here. Two more. Last one. Very good. Now, let me look and remember what I wanted to do. All right. We're going to be here. We're going to start just bringing the hands up. Now, the difference here is instead of typical flexion, our palms are up. Your arms can be bent a little if you like. Belly button in. You can feel your core at work. Very good. Now, of course, we need to add a little more to it, the shoulder width apart. Let's add a squat. Nice little squat. Again, your chair is behind you. Your rear is moving back. That's the most important thing about a squat. It's kicks up the butt. It's like traveling front and back. The knees are not traveling at all. That's what protects them. Now, you can either be here. This is one. This is a little more difficult. Honestly, it's easier to go down here. Up. Two. Let the arms go down and up. But you can decide either way. All right, we're almost done. Very good. Shake it out. We're going to go back to the hip flexors. All right, now we were here. You can stick with this. If this is a challenge for you, but if you feel good with it, then don't touch the floor. That's a bigger challenge because it's much more of a balance challenge. Works your core more. Let's switch sides. So remember, you can touch the floor every time, or you can choose to not touch the floor. Find you have a chair or the wall nearby, or just touch the floor. Very good. Now you can do the more of the kick, but it's not a kick. The leg extended. We just have time for two. Very good. Set your weights down. It's the last cardio. It's the easier one of the two, of the three. Remember this? We've got this down. Oh, it's so much nicer when you can hear me talking back here. So it's the back step. We're going to throw a jack in here in a minute. After this front one, we're going to go two jacks. Now keep stepping backwards. So we do three parts of a box. Complete it the second time. Let's add those jacks back in. Now you could choose to just do one arm on either side with the jack. Start it over. Front. Now you decide. The wider the feet, the more work it is. Here are the jacks. You can do both arms. You can just go shoulder height. Take it back behind you. And front. And back. Back to those jacks. If you wanted, the jacks could be all the way. It could be quite big. You decide. Start it over. We're going to add the mambo next time. Very good. Ready for those jacks. However you want to do them, here they are. We're doing the back part. Back of the box. Front of the box. Back of the box. Jacks. Mambos are coming up next. Here come the mambos. On the right, it's just front and back. Again, you decide how big the step is. Here we are on the other side. Add the arms if you like. Start it over. Right foot is leading everything right now. We'll let the left lead in a minute. Jacks, we're going to go all the way through the pattern this time so that we can move to the other side. Take it back. Front. Back. Here are those jacks. Two of them. That's it. Here's the mambo. You can let the arms follow the feet just for extra cardio and coordination. Or you can just do the mambo. Now we're going to do the steps. Four. Three. This means we're moving over here. Now start with the left foot. All the same moves. It's just the left foot leading. Stick with that box step. Make sure we're all here together. We're all using the left foot. Let's add the jacks right here. Left. Right. Left leads everything now. Go back. Again, you're deciding with the width of these steps. Partially how big this is. Jacks and how big this step is. Very good. Keep going from the top. We'll add the mambas this time. Here's the first set of jacks. This is it. Good. We're going back. That's it. Front. Back. Here's your jacks. Mambos are coming up next. Are you ready? Left foot first. Mambo. You can just do the leg. You can add the arms. Other side. Get ready for the four steps. Four, three, two, and to the other side. Grapevine. You start the whole thing from the top. Right foot leads now. We've got it. We know what it is now. Here's the jacks. That's it. Right's leading. Back. Maybe you're doing really wide feet. Maybe you're not. You decide. Jacks. Get ready for mambo next. Are you ready? Here it is. Right. Left. Here come the four steps. Here they are. Ready? It's four. Three. Two. Right, fine. Let's see how far we can get into it with a left leg. Not very far, I don't think. two. Oh, let's see if we can get the jacks in maybe at least. Jacks. I'll go ahead and do the last jack. Very good. You're all done. Grab your drink. Grab your chair. Your drink and your chair. I found another song. It's kind of hard to try to find ballads but that aren't so slow that we can't feel the beat, but that are at least 4 minutes long. That's harder than you think. This one's a little shorter than some of the others. Grab that drink. We'll start it over again. You're still moving. Getting that drink if you need it. Rolling those shoulders back. Bring that right arm out. It is straight across. You're pulling it towards you. I know you hear me say the same things over and over, but this is just from years of experience. Seeing people live, it takes a long time for some people to get this. That is not this, it's this. That's where you feel the stretch. Now bend it, touch the shoulder, pull on this, rotate that foot so that you feel a stretch in your hip as well as the back of your arm and your shoulder. Very good, other side. Bring it straight across the front. If you guys ever have suggestions of music, let me know. I can't always use everything. It depends sometimes on the tempo, but I can play with the tempo. I'm just, you know, looking for new stuff. Pull it towards you. Some things I slow down, like Crocodile Rock. Some things I speed up, like Shadow Dancing. All right, bend that arm. Pivot on that toe. There was something. Very good. And release, roll those shoulders back. Roll them again. I'm actually gonna start the song over, believe it or not, one more time. I wanna give us a little more time. And now we're gonna come, remember, keep moving if your heart rate's up, but if not, then get a hamstring. I want us to give a little extra stretch for that lower body. Because we did some very good stretch work there. Remember, you could be here or here, either one. Straight line, that's absolutely essential. Only come forward if you can keep a straight line. It really matters. I see so many times in gyms, people think they're stretching, they're doing stuff like this, and they're bent here, and they're not getting near the stretch they would if they just did this. Very good. Release. Come back to the other side. Very good. Same thing. Remember, heel down, butt's going back. Straight line, straight line. Hipping at the hip is key. Flexing that foot is key. You can be here, or you can put it on a pillow, a box, a stool, a step, a chair. Just keep it straight. And keep that foot really flexed. Sometimes a foot starts going out and you don't notice, but see if it can come back towards you more. You'll feel it right there in that calf. Very good, release. We definitely want to get the quad in today. We worked it extra today. So remember, it's perfectly fine to just have it here. Here, use your strap to catch around it. Grab the edge of your shoe. Do what works for you. But we're trying to be tall and straight. So again, much better than being here, which I see people do, would be to be here and hit the hip back and the legs straight. It's a far better stretch. Very good, and release. Let's come to the other side. Remember, you could just be here. That would work just fine because my hip is back, but you can't really see that here. See, we're stretching the hip here. If you're here, or wherever you are. Very good. Woo, stretch it out. Now, feet close together. I want to get the abductors. Head over. Remember, you can grab here if you want. Breathe. There was something. All right, and this way. Gotcha. Baby, come back. Now I want you to actually sit in the chair. Any chair around real quick. And we're going to do this stretch. Remember, it could be here, here, here. But I want you to get deep down in those glutes. This is a good thing to use the chair-based yoga class because we'll do this stretch a lot in it and some of these stretches for lower body. Switch sides. It could be here, here, or here. Stay nice and tall because we did all the squats. We did the stuff for hip flexors, so this is the opposite side. We want to stretch both sides. Very good. And behind your chair, I want you to come way back like this. Spread your feet as far apart as you need to, all right? Hip flexor. We're trying to stretch that as well as the calf. Very good. Switch sides. Everything about you. You're thinking of pressing the heel towards the floor, but I want you to be open. If you're right here, you're not really getting your hip flexor, or probably your calf very well. or here, or maybe you could be here, here, or here. See, the song's going to end before you finish, even though I started it over. Bring it way over. Maybe not. Very good. Woo, that's good for your shoulder and your neck. So we're here, even if you can just get here, that's all right. This gives us a shoulder stretch. This gives us that trap stretch here in the neck and shoulder. This gets the back of the neck. Release. Woo, open up wide. Now try to pat yourself on the back, way back here. Pull it up. Other arm on top, way back. Reach it up. Oh, roll it back. Inhale, up, 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 up. Big breath in. Let it all out. Great job, everybody.